Okay, so this is the first version of the Virtual Broom plugin. So to get there, you just need to load a point cloud and highlight it in the main database, and then click on the Virtual Broom plugin icon, which is currently a small broom. So the first thing you see is the cloud in a dedicated 3D view. You can interact with the camera in the usual way. The first thing you need to do before using this tool is to position the broom somewhere on the cloud. Then the broom will stick to the cloud surface. So you have to click on the reposition button and define two points. One there and one there, for instance, and the plugin will automatically position this virtual broom between the two points. The broom here is the yellow box, and above the broom there's this red transparent box that represents the selection area. This selection area can be set up with this part of the tool. You have different modes, so you can select the point inside the broom or above, just as the default mode. You can also select the points below the broom and above and below. So we'll keep with the above mode by default. You can set the selection area height, and you can also change the dimensions with the other parameters. The width and the thickness are always the relative to the length for now. So now the only thing you have to do is to move the broom above the surface, and the plugin will select, you can see in red, the points falling inside the selection area we have defined. So you can simply display the broom. The broom will always stick to the surface, and even if the surface is a bit curvy, as long as the broom is not too large, it should stick to the surface properly. You can even go on this sidewalk, for instance, as it's not too far from the road. It's almost the same orientation, so the broom can jump on the sidewalk without any problem. Yeah, for this sidewalk also. You see on the trees that we don't get the points outside of the selection area, so we can, for instance, increase its height. Of course, the bigger the selection area, the slower the tool will be. But as long as the cloud is not too big, it should be quite smooth. So anytime you can decide to remove the points, the selected points. Optionally, you could also ask the plugin to do the opposite selection. But for now, we'll keep the default mode. And so we can click on apply to remove the points and have a clearer view of the remaining points. So you can see that we still have some points above the surface because the broom is quite thick. So we can reduce the broom thickness anytime. We will also reduce the size here because we don't need such a high broom. 2 or 3%, yes. The main issue with a very thin broom is that it will be harder to stick to the surface But for instance, for roads, it's not really an issue. So we can restart the process with a thinner broom. So this way we get much more points. We see here on this part of the road that we are reaching the noise limit of the cloud, but maybe also because the road is a bit curvy on this part. I think that we have both reasons here. Yeah, the sidewalk is definitely either much noisier or simply the roughness is higher. So this is a good opportunity to show that we can undo at any time the selection. So you can either undo one step at a time or 10 steps to go much faster. So we'll simply undo our selection on the sidewalk. And yes, we are missing some points over there. In the case we go outside of the road, yeah, the plugin will detect it automatically and will stop the movement of the broom. Either we are able to get the broom back to the surface, but sometimes it loses the track definitely. So in this case, it's better to undo until we reach a position that worked before. And when we are done, once again, we can apply the segmentation, the selection. And we now get a much cleaner surface. Eventually, when we are done, we simply click on the validate button.